Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijer, a retired lecturer of Matari preaching Christianity and Sikhism, and here I'm going to give you discourse on the part played by Satguru Angad Dev Ji. Now, the part played by Satguru Angad Dev Ji was to prepare the grounds for a Sikh to reach the spiritual heights, and he prepared the stepping stone for them, and the stepping stone was to kill your ego. So that's in the village Khadur where he was moved to. Over there, he preached them the gospel, telling them that everyone which is born in this world has been provided with the food to live. You can see, you know, that some fish is deep in the sea, where sometimes people think, no, they can't live because of the pressure of the water and all that. But they have been provided with the food there too, and they live. So you will find that there are bacteria which do not need oxygen to live. And there are so many other things. You can see these lizard in the desert. You might think there is nothing to eat in the desert, but they still live, you know, they find their food. So what Satguru Angad Dev Ji stressed, do not be worried about what you eat tomorrow. Worry about His will. Submit yourself to His will, and you will get everything. What we call man chindya phal. Man chindya phal means what is in your mind. Now the man chindya phal is different from tan chindya phal. Many people, you know, they clerics in the Gurdwaras, they think of Manchindya Phal as money, material wealth. It is not so. Manchindya Phal, the desire of your mind is to know gospel. And gospel treasures are what your mind longs for, not the material things. So Satguru Angad Dev Ji then told them, don't give importance to what you should eat today or tomorrow, as Christ Jesus said, you know, but just leave it to your Father, and He looks after you. He will provide you food, everything. Whenever you want to go die, you will die. Nobody can stop it. So why to worry? So in Satguru Angad Dev Ji, then they killed the ego of the people. Ego, as you know, there are five temptations of the heart, and three are dependent upon ego, and two are of mind. So the three which are of ego, they are your physical birth in a tribal family or in other place, in a white or brown colored family, rich family, poor family. This is the by birth, you know, you can have ego. And that ego is to be subdued, because when you are born, it was not your will that you would be born in such and such family. It's God who gave you the birth. He sent his soul into that family. So that is the first will of our Father, that do not conceal your tribal identity. As I explained earlier, a person who knows his tribal identity and place of residence, that identifies himself, he is called a Hindu. Hindu is from the word hond. Hond means your existence. So unless you are a Hindu, you cannot be a Sikh. So if you renounce your temporal father or secular father, then how will you love your spiritual father? The secular father brought you up, gave you his property, make you stand in this world, and you say bye-bye to him. If you are unfaithful to your secular father, you cannot be faithful to your spiritual father, God. So the first step in the religion is that be of your secular father, or be a son of a man. If you renounce your secular father in favor of somebody else, they say you are a son of a Sikh, or son of a Jew, son of a Muslim. These are spiritual selves. You cannot be son of spiritual selves. You are son of the tribal selves. So when you become son of a Sikh, then you say bye-bye to your tribal father, and you become a self-made bastard. And when you become unfaithful to your tribal father, then God doesn't want to know you. And this was the reason why Jesus was born of a virgin. So first step is that you should retain your tribal identity where the God has given you birth. And second, ego is of physical smartness. You may be a wrestler, a footballer, or anything, and that pumps your ego up. So subdue your that ego. This Satguru Angad Dev Ji, he subdued it through wrestling matches. He promoted wrestling, and the wrestlers, as you know, get ego in their mind, that they are very strong, whom they care, and all that. So the strength, he said, bend it to serve people, not to beat them. So they used to present their other cheek if somebody hit him. They didn't fight back. So these two, the third ego is of the book knowledge. You know, these Brahmins and these rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they get proud that I have read 100 books, 200 books, this book, that book. But the gospel is not in the books. Gospel is in your heart. So if you clean your heart of this old wine, the knowledge of the books, and create a new vessel inside you, you cannot learn gospel. So this knowledge should be subdued also to the will of God. So in the next video, I will explain to you what type of attainment Satguru Angad Dev Ji got, and then he handed it over those Sikhs to the next Satguru to be taken to the next spiritual step. And hope you will understand it, and I will try to make it clear as much as possible. And God bless you.